speak about photovoltaic properties predicted and improved by using ab initio calculation. Don't be afraid, I will present some calculation, but it will they will be compared every will be compared to experimental data. Today I my talk will be organized in this form. I will present a DFT, but a touch. Don't be afraid, it will be a short comment about DFT, and after I will show some talk about simulation and prediction of optical dielectric constant, optical absorption and reflectivity, photoelectron conductivity and quantum efficiency. And also I will present from calculation the crucial optical parameters such as circuit opened voltage, short circuit current, and photovoltaic power. And at the end of my talk, I will speak about, will show you that after DFT, it is possible to design a device, a photovoltaic device. I mean the choose of materials and to tune dimensions. Okay, this is a DFT, but from an experimental point of view. It's an approximation, and this approximation consists to replace a real system by another system. In the real system, everything is moving nucleus and electrons, and the new system, we will have only one moving electrons, but in the field created by frozen nucleus and distribution charge of the other electrons. Here we have to resolve a Schrödinger equation, but for in particles, which is not possible. And here we have another equation. It's also equation to Schrödinger, but we have another parameter which a big effort is requested to calculate these parameters. This parameters, its expression depends the material on which we will work. Okay, and trust me that we can calculate nanoparticles such as nanowire. Yes, of course, bulk, nanowire, surfaces, and superlattice, and nanoparticles. This calculation already dedicated to the photovoltaic materials, so I will calculate all parameters from DFT, all photovoltaic parameters from DFT. Okay, the photovoltaic device is presented here. I have the calculations concerns this perovskite. The device consists to have two materials, one material, so two layers. One layer is can transport electrons, and another this one it's a layer. Transport holes layers, and between them we put our perovskite. And when this perovskite receives photons, there is a current which can be collected out of the device. The diagram energy of war for bands is presented in this form. Here, this is our molecule, it's a perovskite, and this is its layers, it's electron transport layers, and this one, it's, which is a spiroamidite, which is a holes out transport layers. When this our materials receive a photon, one electron can transit from band valence to the Dukand band action. And this Dukand band action of the second layer is at a lower energy, so the electron transit jump to this lower conduction band, and after go firstly, he can't transit to the valence band because this band is full, and the unique solution it go from four next layer, which includes some holes, and when it's in this band balance, after he can. He jumps to lower energy, which is the valence band of our material. And after receiving another photons, the phenomena is repeated. Okay, this calculation for structural electronic of for our materials. For perovskite, this is a total density of state. We have here a gap, which we can extract precisely, and we found about 1.75 electron. It is close to the experimental value, but we will see that when I calculate absorption. The accordance between calculation and experiment data will be nice. Okay. Now we will analyze the optical transition with precision. And here I present all projected density of state of here. The contribution to the density of electronic, which come from the organic part, and here it's for iodine atoms, and here for Pb atoms. Okay, as you know that the transition takes place when the difference between bands is plus or minus one. We will use this condition, and we will analyze which atom is responsible to transition when the photovoltaic phenomena takes place. This is, as you can see, close to Fermi level, because zero is Fermi level is taken as reference. At zero, we have a Fermi level, and the contribution from this organic part, the source so far from Fermi level. So there is no transition. This part doesn't contribute to transition. Here we have density of state. We will see that it doesn't contribute also to transitions. Okay, then there is no contribution from these atoms, and we have only a contribution from S band to P band, which in Pb atoms. Probably we can, a transition is expected from this band from iodine atoms to do one band here, but if we consider this conditions, there is no the transition is formidden if we consider these conditions. So the final conclusion, the transition or phenomena of photovoltaic taking place in photovoltaic devices comes only from transition from S band S and the P band of Pb atoms. Conclusion, only Pb atoms induces a transition in the a photovoltaic device. Now from No, from electronic structure calculation, we can calculate optical dielectric constant, which includes similar information. This is calculation start firstly to calculate the part imaginary of optical dielectric constant from wave function in conduction band and in the valence band. And this operator is the operator which expresses the interaction between photon and electrons. When we calculate the imaginary part, we also can estimate or calculate the real part on using this formula. So now we calculate the imaginary part and the real part, and the complex dielectric constant is written as we can see here. Now we have a real part and imaginary part, and from that we can calculate absorption, reflectivity, and conductivity. All these parameters, all this quantity will be calculated and will be compared to the experimental data. The absorption, the optical absorption is given by this formula. The reflectivity is also given by this formula, and the conductivity is obtained from this expression. Okay. Here we calculate the imaginary part of optical dielectric constant. It's black points. And here is this curve, they come from experimental measurements. And even we analyze the experiment curve, there is no similarity between imaginary part coming from different measurements. Why? The reason is when we obtain a perovskite materials, rigidity and sometimes the humidity deposited on the surface of material, which affects strongly the signal or the measurements of imaginary part of optical dielectric constant. Here also we calculated the optical absorption, and here is the triangle here, and also I come back here. Even if the shape is not very similar, but the scale rest the scale is correct, is still correct comparing with this experience. This conclusion is also can be considered for the optical absorption. If we see here that our calculation is close to the measurements, and the difference on the deviation comes from the surface, because some surface has more rigidity, more layer of humidity of perovskite. And here, it's an important parameter for photovoltaic phenomena, is the quantum efficiency. It obtained from reflectivity error and absorption coefficients using this formula. And we have it. I have now the experimental data to compare, but this quantity, I will easy to calculate other parameters which will be compared to the experimental. Here I calculated the photocurrent, which is very important for photovoltaic. By this calculation, they are performed by using this formula. And this is the flux, and this is the quantum efficiency that I presented in the last slide. This is the flux at level C, and here the flax by the quantum efficiency times the flux, and I have this shape. Okay. Now, the task of this calculation is not to perform calculation, but to discuss value which comes from experimental. Here we have open circuit voltage. Open circuit voltage is simply given by this formula. We take the gap and divide by electrons. And we have automatically the VCO, the open circuit voltage, which is very important for a photovoltaic device. And here, when I integrate this absorption, I find that the VCO is about 1.5. And this morning, our colleagues for Nazaruddin showed one experimental VCO which was in nice accordance with the formula extracted from electronic calculations. This reduction is due to the resistance between materials. Here I calculated, but I don't take in consideration the resistance.
Here
When this is our perovskite, when the perovskite receives one photon, a transition takes transition from one electron takes from the band valence to the band conduction of perovskite, and when the electron is excited in this band conduction, another band conduction from the oxide the titanium is lower, so the electrons goes to lower energy, and now takes place at the band conduction. Here it's a fun band, so the electron is obliged to go here, which this is material. It's a hole transport material. There is some holes. Electron take place here, and really take place here. The band balance of perovskite is now without our main electron jump to the band balance of perovskite. And the material receives another photons, the phenomena is repeated. And with this manner we have the phenomena for photovoltaic, which can give you electricity, but some efficiency is not high. Okay. This material is not easy to study because it's a big, the molecule is a big organic molecule. The calculation is very consuming time. This is oxide, and DFT doesn't like oxide. The calculation they are very difficult for oxide and for spirometry. Now we will try to calculate something which is easy, which is the materials they are easy, but materials they are not. But when we show you the when we reduce or tune the reduction, the gap is changed, as you can see in this example. When the dilution varies from low value to higher value, we have a variation of wavelength from this value, and it increases this value. So the conclusion, when we can tune the size of particles, we can tune the band gap and the position band condition of metals with our perovskite. So show you that we modify the size of particles. Here, this is metal and is conductor. When I create or realize nanometers from these metals, like such as nanowire, the materials behaves as a semiconductor or a selector. Here we have another example, which is a particle, not an anion, but with a particle, and see that the density of states is completely changed. So with this example, I want to show if we modify the size of metals, we can tune the position, the band, the conduction of the metal with respect with the band, the conduction of our perovskite, like here, up. So we can replace this complicated materials, pyro, and this oxide, which is not easy to calculate by a metal. This metal, we have to change the dimension of a particle. this shift between band condition between two given materials is also responsible for the thermoelectric phenomena. Here, I gave a short comment for thermoelectric materials. What's time about? When I apply a voltage, I have one side is cold and one side is hot. The explanation is given by this moving. Here, when I apply just voltage, the electron take place here. This is a thermoelectric materials with the band conduction is a shift comparing to the band conduction of metals. When I apply a voltage, the electron take place at the band conduction in metals, but they have now enough energy to charge the band conduction in the thermoelectric materials, which allows them to move. So the missed energy is coming from collision between electrons and vibrating atoms. As consequence, the electrons jump and I have less, the vibration is reduced. At the next side, the electrons jump to the lower energy, losing some part of energy, and some part of energy is transferred to surrounding electrons. As consequence, we will have this situation. Here we have less vibration, it's here, and here we have more vibration. And as a final consequence, the temperature decreases on this side, and the temperature increases on this side. And the structure electronic or the DFT can allow us to calculate the phenomena of thermoelectric. I will show just one formula. Thermoelectric properties is expressed by thermopower, which is given by this formula. We can calculate the thermopower S or cubic coefficient using this formula, where sigma is the conductivity, and in the conductivity we have velocity and lifetime of electrons. When we perform integration of this quantity in the reciprocal space, we have this quantity that we put here, and we will have a cubic coefficient. And here we have comparison between experimental and calculation, and we, as you can see, this is a nice accordance between experimental and calculation for this materials. Okay, I'll finish it, thank you.